So I'm joined here today by Mama G, who is part of Petite Pantos, or you are Petite Pantos. Tell us what it's all about, Mama G, because you've got, it's a really good event which has happened over, I think you've got 7 sessions at the Warren outdoor session, which is next to Brighton Pier. Tell us what you're going to be getting up to.
What I do is I'm a storytelling pantomime dame. So I go all over the country normally telling stories about being who you are and loving who you want. Now, I've spent the last 4 or so months in my living room just minding my own business. So I was very excited when Boris Johnson said we could perform in the outdoors at least. And I was even more excited when I discovered that the Warren is presenting an outdoor season right on Brighton Beach. Yeah. And I got in touch with them and I said, I would love to perform, please, because I first started telling stories in Brighton. So I am coming down to Brighton with my Storytime Roadshow. It's called Mama G's Storytime Roadshow. And it's 50 minutes of songs and stories all about being who you are and loving who you want. And the best thing about it is that it's suitable for the whole family.
Which is great. So what kind of stories are you telling during this show? What can we expect? Because I know it's very inclusive, and inclusiveness is a big part of what you do.
Absolutely. I think it's so important that we teach inclusivity to people of all ages, because adults need to be taught it too. And if we can get children understanding about acceptance and inclusivity from a very young age, then eventually we won't need to teach it to them, which will save me a lot of time. But my stories, they're all written by me. And I have a cast of crazy characters who I will be presenting to my audiences. Probably one of my favorites is a horse called Eunice, who is a little bit confused about what she's supposed to be. And she ends up realizing she is meant to be something incredibly magical, but I will not give the story away. I've got a couple of fairies called Fran and Vera, who are a good fairy and a bad fairy. And they've got a good friend called Silly Billy, who's fallen in love with someone. And the fairies argue over whether he should be in love with this person or not. And one of them tries to find him some alternatives until she learns her lesson. I've got one of my characters saves Bonfire Night by dancing, which is a lot of fun. I've got a dinosaur who makes hats, a little T-Rex, who finds he has a passion for hat making, and he discovers who he is through that. I've got lots of other stories as well. I think one of the stories I'll be telling on Saturday is called My First Pride, because I know that a lot of people this year will have unfortunately missed out on their first Pride experience. So I put together a story that involves lots of gay anthems and suggests to you what it might be like to go to your first Pride, no matter what age you are. And my stories involve a lot of joining in, audience interaction, songs, singing, puppets, a bit of magic. There may even be some trumpet playing. Who knows?
Excellent. So how do people get more information, how they book tickets? It's through the Warren Outdoor Sessions website, I'm guessing.
It's very easy. You just need to go to warrenfestival.co.uk and then you just need to search for Mama G's Storytime Roadshow and book your tickets. They're selling tickets per table, so you buy 6 per table, but they're very reasonably priced. So even if it's only 2 of you coming from one household, it's still not very expensive.
Yeah, we spoke to Nikki Hayden, who's, you know, managing everything, and it certainly is it's a brilliant spot there next to the pier. Mama G, just tell us a bit about the backstory, because I know that it's really interesting about how you got into to doing this. So just tell us a bit about that, because it's really important, isn't it, that people... you know, people are who they want to be, and that, you know, that they're allowed to be who they want to be as well. This is really quite central, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. And I've thought that for a very long time. Yeah. And I've been a pantomime dame for about 15 years, even though I know I don't look old enough. But 2 years ago, I was performing at the Brighton Fringe with Petite Pantos. We were presenting Mother Goose, which is a very old school pantomime. And traditionally, Mother Goose is a storyteller. And I was looking for a way to promote the pantomime. And I realized that I could go to places and tell stories. So I contacted lots of places in Brighton. And the Cowley Club got back to me, which is an amazing place. And they said, we'd love for you to come in and tell stories. And I decided I was going to tell stories about being who you are and loving who you want. So I that's where I wrote my fairy story, the fairies Fran and Vera, who are the good and bad fairies. So I wrote it for that. I went to your local Waterstones and I bought some books. I bought the a book about Rosa Parks, who's one of my heroes, and she's done incredible things for the civil rights movement around the world. Yes. And I bought another book called Julian is a Mermaid, which is about a boy who wants to become a mermaid. I took them with me to the Cowley Club. I sat down and I told these stories to a smattering of families. And it was really a wonderful experience because at the end of the session, I asked the children what their favorite bits about my story had been. And one of them said that her favorite bit was at the end, the main character realized that he could love whoever he wanted. And I thought, well, this is an incredible message to be passing on to younger generations. And it's incredible for older generations to be able to hear young people say that this is a message they think is important and that they understand and that they're capable of dealing with and want to promote. So, and from there, I just carried on. I'm relentless now.
Yeah, we've spoken to Nikki Hayden, who's, you know, managing everything, and it certainly is it's a brilliant spot there next to the pier. Mama G, just tell us a bit about the backstory, because I know that it's really interesting about how you got into to doing this. So just tell us a bit about that, because it's really important, isn't it, that people, you know, people are who they want to be, and that, you know, that they're allowed to be who they want to be as well. This is really quite central, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. And I've thought that for a very long time. Yeah. And I've been a pantomime dame for about 15 years, even though I know I don't look old enough. But 2 years ago, I was performing at the Brighton Fringe with Petite Pantos. We were presenting Mother Goose, which is a very old school pantomime. And traditionally, Mother Goose is a storyteller. And I was looking for a way to promote the pantomime. And I realized that I could go to places and tell stories. So I contacted lots of places in Brighton. And the Cowley Club got back to me, which is an amazing place. And they said, we'd love for you to come in and tell stories. And I decided I was going to tell stories about being who you are and loving who you want. So I that's where I wrote my fairy story, the fairies Fran and Vera, who are the good and bad fairies. So I wrote it for that. I went to your local Waterstones and I bought some books. I bought the a book about Rosa Parks, who's one of my heroes, and she's done incredible things for the civil rights movement around the world. Yes. And I bought another book called Julian is a Mermaid, which is about a boy who wants to become a mermaid. I took them with me to the Cowley Club. I sat down and I told these stories to a smattering of families. And it was really a wonderful experience because at the end of the session, I asked the children what their favorite bits about my story had been. And one of them said that her favorite bit was at the end, the main character realized that he could love whoever he wanted. And I thought, well, this is an incredible message to be passing on to younger generations. And it's incredible for older generations to be able to hear young people say that this is a message they think is important and that they understand and that they're capable of dealing with and want to promote. So, and from there, I just carried on. I'm relentless now.
And there is an art to storytelling, isn't there? So what's the art? Because and it matters kind of who the age range is. I mean, last time I did storytelling, I was volunteering at a nursery, and you know, there's a certain way of doing it. So, you know, people retain their interest, put it that way.
Joy of being a pantomime dame is that I am designed to appeal to every generation of a family. So I have a little bit of something that everyone can enjoy. And I think what adults are always surprised by is the fact that even my stories for the youngest children are full of laughs for the adults. And there's little asides that aren't rude, but that adults will understand. I have one story called The Billy Goat's Guff, in which Billy Goat has two sisters called Millie and Vanilli. So we get quite a lot of humour out of Millie and Vanilli's failed pop career. And obviously the children go, I don't know who Millie and Vanilli are, but the parents are wetting themselves with laughter because I'm referencing a 90s pop scandal.
Excellent. Okay, so if people go to the Warren, then the Warren website, outdoor sessions, they'll be able to book the tickets. And tell us the dates again, and one last time, please.
I am opening at 11:30 in the morning this Friday, the 7th of August. And then I've got another show this Saturday, the 8th of August. It's at 10 o'clock. And then I'll be back on the 21st, the 28th of August, and the 11th through to the 13th of September.
Brilliant. Okay, we'll leave it there. All the best with the show, and we'll speak to you soon.